Hey folks, this is Ben with the Hot Dog Cart Store and LearnHotDogs.com, and I am sitting here with Castro Dawgz. I am excited to be here with him. He's got a cool story, and he's here with his wife and their five kids. And so you may see some kids run through every now and then, but we're gonna find out how they got started and where they're planning to go with this thing. So stay tuned. So go ahead and tell us, I'm going to ask easy questions, brother. It's going to be easy. Tell me what got you into this? What made you go, you know what, I'm going to do hot dogs?
7 years ago, I was diagnosed with schizophrenia, and, my doctor said I couldn't work anymore.
You kind of proved him wrong, didn't you?
No.
You kind of proved him wrong.
Yeah. I certainly did. Yeah, I did. It was something that was always on my mind. And at the time when we first wanted to do it, my wife said it wasn't a good idea because of my sickness. And I waited a while, and I got better and better. And then I decided one day, I said, I'm going to get a cart. And I found one on Craigslist, and I asked the guy if he wanted to trade for one of my motorcycles. And he was like, yeah. And we got it and started watching your videos. And then my wife bought your book before we opened the cart.
So did you, what did you start with? Did you start small? Did you start, like, how big was your menu when you first started? And how long have you been starting that?
A week.
So this is brand new.
Yeah. We got an all-American cart, and it has the extra grill attachment and also a fryer that I use as the boiler to boil my dogs. And then I use the bottom steam tables for my chili and everything else.
So give me a spread of what your menu consists of right now.
Chili dogs.
Jalapeno chili. Those are my two biggest ones. The jalapeno chili dog is the most biggest one right now that we have. Then the chili dog, and then we have a new porker that is bacon, onions, and barbecue sauce on big 4-to-1 dogs. Right, 4-to-1 dogs. Big 4-to-1 dogs.
So a big quarter pound dog.
Yeah, and then we also do two meatball subs. I got a barbecue meatball sub with bacon and cheese. And it's like a bacon cheeseburger. It's really good. And also marinara sauce with onions and peppers and meatballs.
I like that little fella just walked back there. He's doing a little marketing for you, cuz.
Yeah, I got a lot of kids, man. You'll see them running from here to there.
And now that one's real shy, I can tell. That little fella, he's holding his shirt up. I can tell he's real shy.
Yeah.
So you a pretty good menu as far as not a basic menu, pretty big menu. And tell me about day one and walk us through this, because you've only been doing this a week. So tell me what's happened.
So the first day, I go out there, I put my signs. Well, the day before I start, I go out and we hand out flyers, tons of flyers all around the neighborhood of where we're going to be at. And the next day I come in the morning, I set up and people just start coming.
So the flyers worked?
Yes, the flyers, I got signs, I got big old hot dog, everything in your critique videos, I got it.
Okay. So you did flyers, and they didn't say come get a free hot dog and $5 bill.
No, actually my menu is really cheap. I charge $3 for a dog and $4 for a sub because I want to give the working class person an opportunity to buy food. You know what I mean?
Right, so that it's not, they don't have to.
You know, the prices for food, you go to a food truck, it's like $10, $12, you know what I mean? And we got a lot of truck drivers, there's nowhere for them to go eat. There's nothing else but us.
Well, I'm amazed already you're in this a week, and y'all got swag. I mean, you got swag on your kids.
Yeah. Actually, my brother made my shirts. He has a little printing company, made my shirts and stuff. My wife did all the business cards and, the pictures I sent you, my truck. She did all that, everything. She did the whole marketing, and we went out and did that, and it's been a week, and we're averaging really good money.
I'm impressed, man. It impresses me. I mean, I couldn't afford somebody else's hat when I first started a week into it. I was trying to get off food stamps, you know, and this is just incredible. And so just in this week, what do you think you've learned as a brand new vendor?
It's heavy, hard work. And to get up in the morning and the prep all night, go down there, set up as a, you know, the coolers, checking temperatures, the food, the people coming in, they come in groups, man. They come in, they pull up in groups, they order 3 to 4 to 5 hot dogs each, crazy. And come back home, do the cleanup, all that. It's a lot. We be up to 9, 10 o'clock at night.
Are you figuring out ways to minimize all that workload?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, you know, I talk about that in some of my courses about, you know, figuring out in the beginning it's tricky. You got to get your system down, but then you can figure out stuff. And then pretty soon y'all got a 15-year-old daughter, right?
Yeah.
And pretty soon she's getting allowance because she's cleaning the cart every day and doing the pans. So, what I did, I used my kids at first, but then eventually I had a lady that would, I could drop my cart off to pick it up in the morning. It was ready to go. She did it all. And so she was just wanting extra money. She wasn't looking for a full-time job, and it worked out. Well, there's lots of ways to do that. But I can tell you, I've been where you are. Me and my wife cutting 50-pound bags of onions at 10, 11 o'clock at night, crying. Both because the onions and partly because we're just tired and miserable.
Yeah. You know, other than, you know, I deal with a sickness, so I try to be as perfect as I can be, and she stands by my side through it all, helping me. Like, we're a team, all of us. You know, the 7 of us in this house, we're a team.
Everybody. What's cool to me is you own that, as far as you're not like, you know, secrety about it. I'm not going to go off on a tangent here, but I've got 2 family members with 2 different types of sickness. And because it's not a missing arm or a blind eye, people don't handle it the same way. The world doesn't see it the same way. And so they're like, why can't he do that? Why can't he do this? If they understood that just like they could have a bad heart, you can have a little mess up in the gray matter that doesn't make you a non-functioning person. It just has to be, you have to take meds for this just like you would for your heart. Mm-hmm. So I think it's cool that you own it and you're sharing that with us.
Yeah, well, you know, years ago we were going to first do it. I really wanted to do it, but I thought I can do it.
He wasn't ready. He wouldn't be able to handle the stress that comes with it.
Yeah, I've been in the hospital a couple times for some, you know, relapses and stuff with my sickness. And as throughout the years, I just learned how to deal with it. And keeping busy with the cart, instead of just being at home and just watching YouTube all day, you know, I'm actually out there and with the people. You know, I'm not used to being around people. And it's great. They stay there and hang out with me and eat. And they go and they come back with more people, and it's like a circle of people just coming at me. You just, from far away, you just see all these like, holy crap. And my daughter, she's 13, she's homeschooled, she helps me. She helps me with the soda and everything. See, next year I'm gonna have to do this by myself, and that's gonna be the real trick. You know, that's the real test for me, to do it by myself, you know, because of my sickness and my anxiety and stuff like that. But I'm getting used to it, and it's nice. It's actually nice to be around people again.
Dude, I cannot even tell you. You're giving me chill bumps because I can't imagine what that's like with the sickness to face when you have anxiety, you know, and then to have to put yourself out there and not just kind of be there in a crowd. You got to put yourself out there and be the show. You're the show. You're the main, you're the highlight. You're the lion jumping through the fiery ring. And even though that's in terms of serving a hot dog, but and being friendly and customer service oriented, I think it's kick butt. And then to have your daughter with you helping, that's huge because you're giving her a better education than the public school system would. That's an incredible deal.
My wife works in the building right across from me in the parking lot. Her boss was the one who allowed me to stay there and make the income. You know, I came to him and said, hey, is it okay for me to park my truck outside, you know, to make some income with my wife, you know? And he's like, of course. He don't even charge me. And he comes and he buys his workers food too.
Holy cow, man. You're a week into this. So give me what you're... And I know these things change, but what's your plans going forward?
Well, my plan is because we live in Oregon and it rains a lot and I get my most depression during the wintertime. Like I really get down because I can't leave. I can't ride motorcycles. You know, that's my passion. It's motorcycles and I can't leave the house. So I have anxiety of always being in the house. So our plan is to hopefully save enough money to buy a Stand King. I watched all your videos and that Stand King. That way we can sit, I can sit in the Stand King and it can just rain and people will still come, you know what I mean? And my umbrella ain't gonna keep me dry. And I have tendonitis as well. I just got 2 cortisone shots right the day before, or the weekend before I opened the car. I got a cortisone shot here and a cortisone shot here. And so I'm in pain and I'm still lifting these heavy coolers and I'm still serving dogs and putting the cart together and putting it on the truck and driving it down and running. And yeah, I'm doing it all.
Well, I'll put money on in just a few weeks, a matter of weeks, you'll have narrowed this down and figured out an easier system so that it's not late nights. Oh my gosh, we got to run back out and get onions. Oh crap, we need jalapenos. You know, all the stuff that goes into this, because it is. And until you do it, you can read a book 900 times. But until you do it, then you go, oh, crap. There's a lot of crap involved here.
And we got 5 kids, Ben. We have 5 kids. I got to do it. You know what I mean? I have to fight the voices in my head and the shakes and the struggles that I have. I fight that and I go out and do it, man. Because once I'm out there and doing it, all that disappears. I'm just having a good old time with the people that come to me because that's what it is, fun.
And you know what can happen too for you is, you know, you talked about a Stand King. And you won't have any problem the way you're going already in a week of earning that money so you can do that, invest in something bigger and better. But you could also go a shortcut to it, and we've got vendors doing it. They go find a used trailer and either put in a opening, you know, a concession opening window, or they buy one with it, you know, find a used one that's blank. A blank trailer, and you can find them new for $4,000 to $5,000 with nothing inside. Yeah. Well, now you can roll your cart right in the door and strap it down to the floor with circle rings, you know, eyelets. And now you've got an enclosed trailer for the meantime. I just think this is going to be awesome to watch y'all progress. And I think it's so cool that you got, it's just super cool that you got your kids helping and your family helping and a supportive wife, and who I love her red hair. That it looks cool. And it almost matches the logo.
It does. It does.
I like it.
Hey, you know, we eat a lot of hot dogs in this house too.
I'm gonna have my daughter. I have a daughter in Eugene. Oh. And so what I'm going to do is next time she's going to Portland, I'm going to have her come see you. You can buy a hot dog and film it.
Yeah, we're right by the airport. over there by the airport we're at right now. So
I think that is fantastic. Do what?
She could come down, have a dog, and take a flight same time.
There you go. Tell me this, what's your what advice would you give to a new vendor or somebody considering the business?
You ready?
Make sure you buy the right cart.
Okay.
I have that. My cart is little, but I have those extra things on it and I make it work, you know, but if it was a little bigger, I could do a lot more with it. You know what I mean? And for more revenue, like my meatball subs are big. Someone asked me the other day, how do you have a hot dog cart and you have meatball subs on it too? I was like, you like some subs? He's like, yeah, it's pretty badass, you know?
So where are you sourcing all your stuff? Are you?
We go to 4 different places to get different things. Yeah. Yeah. We use a good dog and people love the dog and we dirty water them. I'm Puerto Rican, so I put Puerto Rican seasoning in the dogs. And
I got a brother-in-law that's Puerto Rican, and he's a chef. And
I'm the same. I've been cooking since 12. Hey, I cooked for her first day, and 13 years later, she hasn't left.
That says something. Well, I think it's cool. I think it's cool too, though, that with the schizophrenia. Mm-hmm. That you said that was diagnosed 7 years ago?
Yes.
And you have such a good wife and family that it probably made y'all closer, but she stayed, you know? And a lot of people would leave, you know? They just leave because they don't understand it, can't understand it. It's hard to understand. And
it was really scary in the beginning.
Well, I can imagine. Most people think that if it's something to do with the brain, all you got to do is just tell yourself not to do that anymore. That ain't how your brain works. So I'm impressed with you, brother. I love you. I thank you. I think you're freaking awesome for getting your ass out here doing this, for being who you are, for helping other people already 7 days in, a week in, and you're helping other people by doing this. The people's lives you're going to touch out there. What you're doing for those kids is phenomenal, okay? And you're going to have freedom like you've never seen. And I don't have a magic ball or a crystal ball, but I know the stuff you sent me, and I'm gonna put into this video those pictures you sent me so that people can see them. I just wish you the best, man. I wish you and your family just anything. And if you need me at all, you call me.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
I'll do what I can for you, but... I cut you off a minute ago. You were telling me Puerto Rican, you spice up that dirty water with some Puerto Rican seasonings, right? Yeah. So, and what else? We were talking about sourcing all this stuff.
Well, yeah, we go through 4 different places. So we're constantly running from store to store, picking up this. We got to get to this place before it closes, and we got to get to this place before it closes. And that's how our afternoons are. After we bring the truck, while we're out there shopping, the kids are cleaning the dishes and the cart and getting everything stocked up for the next day while we're out shopping and stuff. And then we come back and we finish everything up. Every night.
Awesome.
It's a routine every night.
I'm glad you're doing it. You're going to look back months from now and go, man, I can't believe we were doing all that crap. Because you're going to figure out easier ways for your life, you know.
Of course.
I love it, man. I thank y'all so much. And I want a dang shirt. If you'll tell me where to buy one, I'll buy one. I think that's cool.
Yeah.
So
we have an Instagram now. We're going to start putting that on and stuff to see if we get more people. I got friends in other places that are trying to bring more people to us as well and stuff. And I get a lot of truck drivers.
That's good.
A lot of truckers, yeah.
That's cool. So where you are at the airport, it must be close enough to an interstate or a highway that truckers are pulling in?
No, it's a trucking company. So we were on the airport.
Oh, gotcha.
They come in and drop their loads and get their lunch and.
And UPS and DHL and FedEx and all the.
And the airlines.
All the airlines, and we're the only truck there.
That is so freaking cool. Yep. That is so cool. That's cool of her boss to do that so that you can to break you in. That's freaking awesome. What would you share? Do you have any last words for us? Anything you want to share that maybe I didn't cover or ask?
I watched your videos and I listened and I watched the stories and I wanted it to be true, you know? And when things are too good to be true, why everybody's not doing it? You know how you always say that? And I had to try it myself because it's something I can do that if I don't feel good or I'm not thinking right, I can stay at home. I don't have to call a boss and be like, you know, and then get fired. You know what I mean? And
that's already happened.
Yeah, you know, so it's like I could do for myself. You know, I don't have to rely on anyone or anything. When I feel good, I go out and work. And when I don't feel good, I just stay at home and fix myself up.
Well, you know what I'm going to do the next time I'm out seeing my daughter is I'm going to come see you. I'm going to love it.
Yeah, have a good old time.
That's it. A redneck and a Puerto Rican.
Yeah.
Well, I appreciate y'all a bunch. And just remember, holler at me anytime. And thanks for the updates, man. You don't know what that does for my heart when I see your updates. I love
it. I send you stuff, man. It's pretty cool. You know, I got a motor from you guys, from my water system and stuff, and I order a couple of things from you guys already. My next one is going to be that King card. That's my eye is on that.
All right. I'll hook you up when you're ready. You let me know.
Yeah, I'll be ready soon, hopefully.
Good. You can do it. Brother, I appreciate it a bunch. Thanks for being here. And the youngins, I love the fact that they're just here with us.
They're everywhere, man. There's a lot of them.
I love it. Y'all have a good evening.
Thank you, man. You too.
See you.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.